Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Asterisk Solution. This video we are going to solve practical 2.2, which is connecting your servlet to a JDBC application. We have been asked to write a program to enter value in the given table, and as you can see the table, the values have ID, name, actor, actress, release date and the rating point. So basically this is a table for adding a movie. We can add some movies inside this and we can start working on this. So what is going to be my strategy for this particular program is that I am going to first create a table, and I will share link in the description box where I have shown you how to make create table if you're new to SQL. Secondly, what we are going to do is go in MySQL, create a table and write a servlet to add the values inside those table, and then come back and accept the values in a parameter. We'll make a form and we'll connect the servlet with the form, and form with the servlet, servlet with the backend program, and it will eventually put the values in the backend. So let's start. This is going to be a long practical, and this is most likely to be expected because this is a tougher one. So you can expect this practical in your exam very much. So let's start with this particular program. So as discussed, the first step we are going to do is create the table. So for creating the table, let's say if this is the first JDBC video, I'll first create a database for you guys. So create database, and let's say BCA practicals, semicolon. The editor I am using here is MySQL front. So you guys can basically look at this, or you can go for the link in the description box where I've shown you how to use. There is a full series on SQL, how to use SQL queries. And next is I'm going to now just creating BCA practicals. Let's say create table. Now don't expect the practicals to come up with this type of IDs. This is what we do here. So I'll recommend you by heart the query, and I know it's not the time to by heart the queries, but you have to do that. So ID int, I name it as primary key and auto underscore increment. Then you have got name of the movie. So name varchar of 100. Then you have got actor varchar 100, comma actress varchar 100, and then you had got release date. So release date is going to be a date, and rating point. So rating point, I'm making it as float, so it will be a value from 1 to 5, can be any decimal values between. Okay, so let's create this table. So the table is created now with ID, name, actor, actress, release date and rating point as it was asked in the practical sheet. Okay, I missed out on the director. Let's add the director. So I'll just add it from the GUI here. Before, I'll just put this before rating points and after actress, name is director. So the table is created now. And the next thing I need to do is write a servlet which is going to insert the values into this. So new servlet, Java package, and let's say movie servlet. I'll need SQL package here, so import java.sql.star in my do post, because I am going to accept the value from my URL here. Sorry, not from URL, but from a form. So I am going to write everything in do post. So print writer pw semicolon. Let's import java.io. So java.io imported response.set content type text slash html. Pw is equal to response.getWriter semicolon. Now, I am expecting 6 values to be coming up from there. So, I am not going to consider ID because I have put it in auto increment. So, let's say string name is equal to request dot get parameter of double quotes name. Same way, I am going to accept all the other values now. I am doing copy paste here, I know that. So, I have to just take care of the variables now. Actor, actress, director, got release date, so I am just marking it as R date here. I'll also name it as R date, and R point, that is the rating point. I'll mark this also as R point, and I have to do what? Convert my rating point to, so rating is equal to float dot parse float of R point. Now next is I need to put this value into the backend. So let's start. Try here class dot for name com dot mysql dot JDBC dot driver. So next I'm going to do what? Start with my try block and class dot for name. So here I specify the name of the driver. So com dot mysql dot JDBC dot driver. and string URL is equal to JDBC colon MySQL colon slash slash localhost colon 3306 slash BCA practicals. So this was my URL. String user is equal to root string password is equal to, for example, in MySQL my password is admin. So I am just going to write admin here. And now let's try to acquire a connection. So connection con is equal to driver manager dot get connection, and I have to pass URL, user and password, the variables I have already defined. So connection acquired. Next is create the query. So string query is equal to insert into movie, and as I am using auto increment, I have to specify the name of the columns I want to enter. So name, actor, actress, director, release date and the rating point values. So how many? 1 2 3 4 5 6. So I have to put up 6 question marks here. 2 3 4 5 6. So this, now let's go for prepared statement. So prepared statement PSTMT is equal to con dot prepare statement of query. So I have created the query now and set the value into those query now. So PSTMT dot set string 1 comma actor, PSTMT dot set string 2 comma, sorry, first one I had name of the movie, so let's put up name here. Second was actor, PSTMT dot set int. Third was actress, PSTMT dot set string 4 comma, I had director, PSTMT dot set string 5 comma r date, which was my release date. And last one, PSTMT dot set string 6 comma, I had, sorry, now here is where I set the rating point. So here it will be set float 6 comma r point. Let me put off this int string here. The name of my rating point variable is not r point, but it is rating, which I later on passed into. And next, int x is equal to PSTMT dot execute update. So what I'm going to do now is just simply post using pw dot println number of, or if basically my value is done properly, if insertion is done properly. So if x equals 1, let's say pw dot println values inserted successfully, end of my if block. So I'll write a catch block here, which will be my exception block. So exception e dot print stack trace, and I save it. So I have got a try, and after my try I have got catch done. So this part is done now, exception is done, and let's say pw dot close. So my servlet is ready, and the next thing I need to do is write a form and just link it. So the name of my servlet is movie servlet. I need to write web form. So I just write an HTML page now, new, and I write an HTML page. Let's say add movie dot HTML. Form method is equal to post, and action is equal to slash BCA practicals slash movie end of form. And I need to write my form here. So enter movie name. Input type is equal to input type is equal to text, name is equal to name, break tag, and I can do some copy pasting here now. Actor, actress, director, release date, rating point, and just keep on changing the names. Actor, actress, director. Next is I have to link it to my release date, so I have named it as r date there and r point here. So again I have to enter rating point, enter release date, then you have got director name, then you have got actress name, and then you have got actor's name. At the end of it, I'm just going to add up a input type is equal to submit, and value is equal to add movie. So I have added this and name. Okay, now let's try to run this. Server have been stopped. I'll just start the server. Server has been started, synchronized. Let's try to run this. So run on server, time start, but it will start now. Starting here, you can see in the lower bottom corner. Yep. So I've got my page now. So I'll, let's say Simba, Ranveer Singh. I am expecting an exception to be occurring here. Okay, Sara Ali Khan, she is my new favorite. Director name was Rohit Shetty. I don't know the release date, but let's say it was somewhere around 2018, 12th December. And rating point 4.3. And the moment I say add, now you can see some exception occurred here. Now we need to check that exception. It's something I was actually expecting to be happening here. That it's not able to find the class com.mysql.jdbc.driver. As we are working in Tomcat environment, we need to give all the dependencies. So to do that, what I'm going to do, I am just going to right click on my project and build path, configure build path, and I need to add the libraries. So add external jar, and I'm going to go and check out for my MySQL connector jar file. I will share the link to find where to download this jar file wherever if you need, in case if you need it. So let's try to run this again. So I say Simba, Veer Singh, Krishna Sara Ali Khan, director name Rohit Shetty, release date 2018, 2012, 20, rating point 4.3, and let's say add the movie, whatever happened. Let's see if some other exceptions have occurred. Okay, still an issue. What we'll do, I'll give you, sometimes this thing happen. What you can do is go in your server folder again, or find your jar file basically. I'm going to just take my jar file and show you how to solve this once and for all. I'm just going to copy this jar file from here by going in the file browser, and in my web content, webinf lib, I'm going to paste it. So that file is now again in my web content, and let's say I run this servlet again, add movie servlet or name. Still starting the servlet now, server now. Tomcat server is starting. And I have made the changes, required changes. I have put it in the build path as well as in the lib folder, which is where it's normally expecting it. So I guess this time this Simba get added. Ranveer Singh, actress name Sara Ali Khan, director name Rohit Shetty, release date 12, and rating point is 4.3. And now I add the movie. I guess again we have hit some exception. No suitable driver found for OK. This is one of the exceptions which can occur. And if you find this, there is no suitable driver found for, I made a mistake in my JDBC URL while typing. Instead of colon, I wrote a semicolon here. So I run it again. Okay. Right click, run as, run on server. I know this is becoming a longer task, but we are done with this now. The codes are in place. It made a small mistake. Just to be sure, my name of the database is correct. Name of my database is proper, practicals. Okay, that's cool. Let's now add it. And I hope this is the final time we are adding it. These are some small mistakes which can occur. You need to make a list that what to do in when you are working. Because even when you are in practical, you are basically in a hurried state of mind. So it might sometime create a problem. So these are some small mistakes. You can make a list of like if this error occurs, what you should do. And I say add movie. Now value is inserted successfully. Now just to be sure what happened there, let's say select star from movie. I run this. You can see the value entered are being here available there. And now this is how you enter a value into the backend. You can find the source code for this whole program on the link in the description box. It is a link to our blog post, and you can also fill up a form which is available there. So that we are going live every week now for explaining you the practicals and again your syllabus of advanced Java, and we are doing live sessions. You are invited for that. You have to just fill up the form and you will receive an email with the link where you will see us there. So this is how we actually entered the value into the backend. Do subscribe to my channel, and you can find the link in the description box or in the playlist for other practicals in your YCMOU advanced Java. Thank you for watching this video.